Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a nice problem sent in by a viewer. Pause the video if you want to give this problem a go. And when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. To begin this problem, if we start by assuming that b is greater than 2, so that c, d and n will all be odd numbers, then this says that the sum of 4 odd numbers is equal to an odd number, which of course is nonsense. So we must conclude that b is equal to 2. And what this also tells us is that since n will be even, c cubed plus d squared must be odd, and hence c and d must have opposite parity. Now, suppose that we said c were equal to some power of 2, so we could write this as 2 to the power of k, for k being greater than or equal to 2, then we are supposing that c is at least a multiple of 4, and the same will be true for n. But if we look at the equation mod 4, then we have n, which would be 0, is congruent to c cubed, which would also be 0, d squared would either be 0 or 1, and 25 would be 1 mod 4. And so this says that 0 is congruent to either 1 or 2 mod 4, which of course is nonsense. So we know that c cannot equal some power of 2, but moreover, this also implies that c must be prime, since suppose c were composite, then that would mean that there would exist some prime number p which is greater than 2, such that p divides c, which would imply that p divides n, and p would be less than c. But then this contradicts the fact that c must be the second smallest divisor of n. So we can conclude here that c must equal to p. And therefore, this implies that d must be even, so we can write this as 2 times m. But by a similar argument, we know that m divides d, which would imply that m divides n, and m would be less than d. But since there cannot be another divisor between c and d, we must conclude that m is equal to c, or m is equal to p. And so d is equal to 2p. And likewise, since p divides n, we could write that n is equal to a times p for some constant a. And so now we can write n as ap is equal to c cubed plus 2p all squared plus 25. And then bringing ap to the right side, we have the following. And by the rational root theorem, we know that if a solution exists, it must divide 25. And so since p divides 25 and is prime, we must conclude that p is equal to 5. And so we have possibilities for b equal to 2, c equal to 5, and d equal to 10. If we sub these three numbers into n, we find that n is equal to 16 plus 125 plus 100 plus 9, which gives a total of 250, which we can then write as 2 times 5 cubed. And it's not too difficult to check here that 2, 5, and 10 are the three smallest divisors of n. And so we're done.